कूजन्तं राम रामेति मधुरं मधुराक्षरम् आरुह्य कविताशाखां वन्दे वाल्मीकिकोकिलं वाल्मीकेर्मुनिसिंहस्य कवितावनचारिणः शृण्वन् रामकथानादं को नयातिपरां गतिम् यप्पिबन् सततं रामचरितामृतसागरम् अतृप्तस्तं मुनिं वन्दे प्राचेतसमकल्मषम् गोष्पतीकृतवाराशिं मशकीकृतराक्षसं रामायणमहामाला रत्नं वन्दे नीलात्मजम् अञ्जनानन्दनं वीरम् जानकी शोकनाशनम् कपीशम् अक्षहन्तारम् वन्दे लङ्काभयङ्करम् मनोजवम् मारुततुल्यवेगम् जितेन्द्रियम् बुद्धिमताम् वरिष्ठम् वातात्मजम् वानरयूतमुख्यम् श्रीरामदूतम् शिरसा नमामि यत्र यत्र रघुनाथकीर्तनम् तत्र तत्र मस्तकाञ्जलिम् बाष्पवारी परिपूर्णलोचनम् मारुतिम् नमद राक्षसान्तकम् वाल्मीकिगिरिसम्भूता रामसागरगामिनि पुनादिभुवनम् पुण्या रामायण महानदी वेदवेद्ये परे पुंसि जाते दशरथात्मजे वेदप्राचेतसादासीद् साक्षात् रामायणात्मना आपदामपहर्तारं दातारं सर्वसम्पदां लोकाभिरामं श्रीरामं भूयो भूयो नमाम्यहं रामाय रामभद्राय रामचन्द्राय वेदसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताया पतये नमः मङ्गलं कोसलेन्द्राय महनीयगुणाब्धये चक्रवर्तीतनुजाय सार्वभौमाय मङ्गलम्
Sri Rama having thus been directed by Sumantara and he had proceeded on to Dasharatha's abode, and as he was going on the way, many many different things he saw, especially the people around in the city have been saying very auspicious words propitiating him and also giving Ashirvada. In this way he proceeded on. Women who were assembled at the palace windows were also giving him very great wishes and throwing flowers, etc. And the people in general who were there in the corners of the streets, they were giving their own Ashirvachana. That is what we see here, verse number 44. एष श्रियं गच्छति राघवोऽद्य
Rajaprasadat Vipulam Gamishyan. Ete Vayam Sarvam Samruddha Kama. Esha Mayam No Bhavita Prashasta. Labo Janasyasya Yadesha Sarvim. Prabhatsyate Rashtramidam Chiraya. Nahya Priyam Kinjana Jadu Kaschit. Pashena Dukkam Manujadi Bespin. Sagosha Vatbischa Haye Sanagai. Purasarai Swastika Suta Magataihi. Mahiya Mana Pravarescha Vadagaihi. Abhishtuto Vai Shravano Yatayayo. Karenu Matangaratashvasankulam. Mahajanogai Paripurna Chatvaram. Prabhutaratnam Bahupunya Sanchayam. Dadarsha Ramo Vimalam Mahapadam. Ramaha Vimalam Mahapadam Dadarsha. Mainly, Sri Rama was on his way to the royal street. Royal street is also known as El Camino Real. In Spanish, El Camino Real. It's a royal street. So he was going in that royal street leading to Dasharatha's place. And people who were there standing by, and they were all priests of him. And what they say, Eshaha Ramaha, Eshaha Raja Prasada, due to the grace of the king, Shriyam Gacchati, he will obtain greatest prosperity. Raghavaha Adya, today. Vipulam Gamishyan, having obtained the great nation or the country, which is by the grace of his own father. Ete Sarva Samruddha Kamaha, all that is prosperity that are available in the country, Vayam for us Naha Bhavita Prashasta Yesha Mayam. Yesha, when these Ayam Prashasta. Prashasta means the king. Prashastru. Prashasanam karta is Prashastru. The one who is doing the Prashasanam, ruling. So Prashasta, he the one, the ruler, when he becomes our ruler, then we obtain the maximum amount of prosperity in this world. Ete vayam sarvam samruddha kamaha yesha mayam no bhavita prashasta. Janasya asya labaha yad esha sarvam prabhasyate rashtramidam chiraya. And if he is chiraya for a long period of time, when he starts ruling this country, janasya asya, for all these people, labaha prabhasyate, we will get all various benefits and other things, because this particular king is, that is Sri Rama, is most beloved, most compassionate, most neutral, and most balanced. And nahi apriyam kinchana jadu kaschit pashyenna dukkam manujadipe asmin. No one ever sees in him anything that is undesirable. Asmin mahadipate manujadipate, and this great king of ours, na kaschit apriyam kinchana pashyet, nothing that he sees in this country when he starts ruling. Nobody will ever hate anyone. Yatha raja tata praja. If the king is wicked and then unruly and then ignoble and then immoral, and then obviously everybody will just repeat Yatha raja. That's why it is said. So here, when he himself was a man of such great compassion, Sagoshavat Vischahaye Sanagaihi. This way everybody is giving Gosha. Gosha means giving a shouting there. Goshavat Vischahaye Sanagaihi, with the horses and the elephants. Purasaraihi Swastika Sudamagataihi. All the people who were different kinds of people who were doing the Swasti. Mahiyamanaha Pravaraischa. And it is raising up, the sound was raising up on the way. Best of the people were there, and vadakaihi, various instruments, musical instrument, abhishtutaha vaishravano yatayayo, he moved in the chariot like that of a kubera. Vaishravanaha yatayayo, he went, and these horses were, the chariots were led by what? Karenu matangarata swashangulam, female elephant, male elephant, horses, all of them. Mahajano gaihi paripurna chatvaram. All the street corners were filled with people. You know, it is like, you know, when we have this January 26 Republic Day in India, right? So what happens? This president stands with the stand like this for 2-3 hours. And various things will be in procession. Like all the armies and then battalion and then air force and... And after that, the people will start, you know, from every part of the country. From Tamil Nadu or Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra and Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh. So all people with dancing and then cultural show, and then they are showing their own state, whatever. In the same way, here is an occasion for Sri Rama to see people from all over the country have come to see a great occasion of coronation of the prince. Therefore, they had to show all their wealth and prosperity. Just like when you have seen, when there is a chariot procession in any city of the presiding deity of that particular temple, then when he comes on the street, everybody will gather around and show, you know, various things. When they put all the vegetables or fruits and other things, offer to the Lord. So in the same way, when Sri Rama has entered the street to reach to the Dasharatha's palace, for not on a normal routine, he is going for to become the king. He is going to be coronated. So people want to demonstrate what all they have. That is why in every corner, Prabhu Taratnam Bahupanya Sanjayam. Panya means what is tradable, commercial. Sanjayam, heaps of them. Prabhu Taratnam, precious stones and other thing, all these things were accumulated and kept for him to see. And Dadarsha Rama Vimalam Mahapadam, thus he saw the royal path filled with people and all the wealth and prosperity demonstrated. Thus he proceeded on to his father's abode. Ityashe Srimat Ramayane Valmiki Adikavya Ayodhya Kante Shodasha Sargah. Actually, I asked somebody to find out how many verses we have completed so far. We have, at this point, we have completed close to around 3050 out of 24,000. And for 3050 verses, it took 3 years for us. So, another 21 years it will take for us to complete. I think I will be alive, I think, you know. I don't know about all of you, but I will be alive.
Now, is it a reality or it was a joke, Swamiji?
I'm not joking. We started in 2013, January, 13, 14, 15. Yeah? In 3 years, 3,000. So you can calculate, 24,000, where it will end. Some people stop coming afterwards, and anyway, we are not going to finish. Why should we come? Anyway. Now, chapter number 17. Saramo Radamastaya Samprahrishta Suhrujjanaha Patakadvaja Sampannam Maharha Guradhupitam Apashyan Nagaram Sriman nana jana samanvitam sagrheirabrashankashaihi pandureirupashobitam rajamargam gayayayo ramo madhyena guru dhupitam chandananam cha mukhyanam agarunam cha samchayaihi uttamanam cha gandanam shomakosham varasya cha avidhabhischa muktabhihi uttamai spatikairapi shobamanam asambhadam tam rajapadam uttamam samvritam vividai pushpaihi bakshairuchchavachairapi dadarsam tam rajapadam divideva patiryata tadyakshata havirlajaihi dupairaguru chandanaihi nana malyopagandaischa sadabhyarchita tatvaram ashirvadan bahun shrunvan sukhrutbhis samudhiritan yatarham chapi sampujya sarvaneva naranyayo ratamastaya ramaha seated in the great chariot samprahishta sukhrutjanaha he delighted all the people there who are all delighted to see him pataka dvaja sampannam maharha guru agaru dhupitam ratam. So the Abhashyan nagaram, the city side was filled with people who are all assembled there, and the pataka, the flags, and also dvaja banners, or the pataka is actually the banner, dvaja is the flag, sampannam, they were all decorated there fully, and maharha, most deserving, aguru means here the agarbatti, you can say, or the perfumes, dhupitam, or the, what do you call that, sambrani kind of thing, they put, what is it called in north, what they do, the dhup, they call dhup, lot of smoke will come out, so that they have put everywhere there. Apashyan, seeing Nagaram Sriman, Nana Jana Samanvitam, of various types of people there. See, India was a melting pot even during those times. Melting pot means what? People from different parts of the world have come and become part of the city there. See, in the past, India was a melting pot in the sense that there were Chinese were there, Mongolians were there, Africans were there, and Arabians were there, because it had the greatest university. Nalanda University and such other universities were there, not during Rama's time, and later on also I am talking about. So, it's interesting, if you go from one part of the country to another part of the country, everything will be different. The face of the people, the style of living, and then the color of the skin, and the eating habits, and the speaking language, and the food habits, and you know, it's because different cultures came and come together to live there. So therefore, people of different races were there. Nana jana samanvitam, of varieties of people, of varieties of cultures, they were all assembled together. So that's why it is, later on, the Britishers have found it very difficult to comprehend what exactly is what they follow. As a religion, they couldn't recognize, because they say that varieties of people, they having varieties of faiths and varieties of worship patterns and so many different deities, you know. So finally, they decided to call this variety as
Hinduism. because they could not comprehend, because they had underlying one single thread, that is Sanatana Dharma. Belief in eternal values. That is the common factor that connected everybody. They believe in the Satya, believe in Ahimsa, belief in Brahmacharya. So therefore, the common factor is only that and not any particular form of God. Unlike a Semitic religious beliefs of believing in one particular form of God and everybody is towards that, here you cannot come to say that this is the particular deity everybody worships, because every time the different places they go, different kinds of gods and different kinds of worship pattern, different kind of faith, different prayers, different language. Forget about it. Together, the people who are living at the banks of Sindh, they are to be called as Hindus. Finished. So, therefore, nanas jana samanvitam sa grihaihi abrasankashaihi, of the houses which are looking like huge clouds, pandurai white mansions, upashobitam, is so beautifully decorated all through the maragam, rajamargam, yayauramo madhyena agaru dhupitam, while various perfumes were being burnt there, chandananam mukhyanam agarunam sa sanchayai, everywhere we see sandalwood and all these perfumes, uttamanam cha gandanam, Kshoma, Kshoma, Koshambarasya cha. And Kshoma means silk. Kosha is silk and Kshoma is the linen. So the silk linen, it is commonly found there, everywhere. So imagine that is such a fine thread and such a beautiful muslin kind of a cloth, and it's found everywhere as torana everywhere. They put it there. Kshoma, Koshamba. Kosha means, you know, the silkworm, it creates a kosha. Kosha means a cocoon, or what you call that as a shell. Kosha is a shell. And Panchakosha, we have also living in five koshas, right? Annamaya, Pranamaya, Manomaya, Jnanamaya and Anandamaya koshas. We are living in five koshas. So outermost is the Annamaya kosha, and within that is Prana, within that is Mana. Apparently, and then Vijnanamaya Kosha and Anandamaya. Within that is the soul. Apparently, that's what we understand that. So, in the same way, the silkworm, having created the saliva, it keeps on making that kosha around it. And then, intelligent human being takes it and puts it in hot water. and removes only the kosha out in the form of a thread. That will dies inside. And we wear this. Kanchipuram. Nalli silk. Nothing but dead. dead silkworm. It's saliva of a dead silkworm. Wear that. Anyway. So this, everywhere they found there. And also unpierced pearls. Avidhabhischa muktabhihi. Uttamaihi and spatikairapi, and also spatikas, crystals, and pearls, everywhere decorated all over the place. And shobamanam asambhadam tam rajapadam uttamam, and this rajapada, as I said, El Camino Real, is such a huge place, asambhadam, not narrow, it's a royal street, huge. And that is found there, samritam vividaihi pushpaihi, and also spread with a lot of flowers, bhakshyaihi, and various eatables, uchchavachairapi, and varieties of them are kept there. Tam dadarsha rajapatam, he saw all of them. Divideva patiryata, as though like Indra walking in the heavens, he moved there. And also dadi, akshata, Havihi, Lajaihi, Dubaihi, Aguru Chandanaihi, Nana, Malya, Mali Upagandaischa, Sada Abhyapchitatvaram. All the corners were filled with yogurt, that is Dahi, Akshata, the Akshata. These are all meant for the sake of worship. The curd, uncut rice, the oblations, havihi, and all the grains, lajaihi, dhupa, everything kept there. You know, it's interesting, we found that when we went to, what is that place? What is that place in Indonesia? It's a lot of one, down below there. Bali. Bali, if you go, we went some years back, every house and every shop outside they keep chandan, kumkum, lamp, flowers and agarbatti. You know, that tradition of worshipping gods at the entrance of houses as well as all commercial places, either it's a shop or it's a restaurant or any kind of shop, they have in the corner. In the morning, they come, first thing they do is to make these flowers in chandan and kumkum and agarbatti, do that, and then only they do anything else. So that tradition was an ancient tradition. In India, nobody follows that. But every corner they had all these things kept, meaning it is all offered to the gods and they kept it there as on the way. So he saw all of them. Sada abhyarchada chatvaram ashirvadan bahun shrunman. At the same time, he had listened to all the various people wishing him well. Suhrudbihi samuduri samyakudhiritan. So everybody is uttering auspicious words. Yadarham chapi sampujya sarvaneva naranyayau. Sarvan naran, all people, he saluted them, each one of them. So with reverentially, as per what they deserve, and he moved about further towards the abode of Sri Dasharatha there. Pidamahe Racharitam Tateva Prapidamahe Adyopadayatam Margam Abhishikto Nupalaya Yatasma Poshita Pitra Yata Sarvai Pitamahaihi Tatasukataram Sarve Rame Vatsyama Rajani Alamadhyahi Muktena Paramartaralam Chanaha Paramartaralam Chanaha Yadi Pashyama Niryantam Ramam Rajye Pratishtitam Tato Hitna Priyataram Nanyat Kinjit Bhavishyati Yadabhisheko Ramasya Rajenamidatetasah. People who were wishing him for Sri Rama to become the king, they say, Pitamahehi Acharitam Tatayeva Prapitamahehi. We have seen Rama's great grandfather ruling this country, his grandfather ruling this country. Adya Upadayatam Margam Abhishikto Anupalaya. May you also, telling Rama, the great kingdom was were ruled by your great grandfather, your grandfather and others. In such a great country, you are going to now rule. We give you all the best wishes. In fact, we were definitely very well taken care by his predecessors. Yatasma Poshita Pitra Yata Sarve Pitamahehi. All his previous kings have very well ruled this kingdom, but Tata Sukataram Sarve Rame Vasyama Rajani. We are very sure we will be taken much better care when Rama becomes the ruler. Not to put down others, but to say that person like Rama, you cannot compare with anybody else. He is the best, and when he starts ruling, we will have Sukataram Sarve Tataha Vatsyama.
will live much better. And we do not want any more of the wealth and even liberation. See, alam. Alam means enough. Alam madhyahi buktena. Even pleasures of the world is enough. We do not want any more. Paramarthaihi alam chanaha. For us, even the paramartha, mukti also we don't want. When? Yadi pashyama niryantam ramam rajye pradishtitam. When we see him coming out of the palace of the king, becoming a prince when he comes out, that is enough for us. We do not want any artha or kama or moksha also. Tatohi na priyataram na anyat kinchit bhavishyati. There is nothing which can be greater than this that will happen to us. Yata abhisheko ramasya rajena amitate chasaha. Unlimited. Amita means incomparable brilliance of Sri Rama. When he gets into be coronated, and that will be the best thing we can ever witness in our life. Imagine Bhagavan himself become the human king, and how wonderful would be such a sight to see. That's why in many of the temples, Rama Pattabhishekha is considered as the most beautiful occasion to celebrate. You have never seen Krishna becoming a king, and nobody bothers about it. But Rama become the king and he taking up the princehood or kinghood, that is surely is celebrated in a great grand manner. Edashtanyasya sugrudam udasina shubha kataha atma sampujani shrunvan yayau ramo mahapadam nahi tasman manakkacchite chakshushi vanarottamat narashaknotyapakrashtum adikrante viragave yascha ramam na pashyetu yamcha ramo na pashyati nindita sarvalokeshu svatmapyenam vigarhate sarveshu sahi dharmatma varnanam kurute dayam chadurnam hi vayastanam tena te tamanuvrataha chaschadushpadan devapadan cha chaityamschayatanani cha pradakshinam pariharan jagamadrupate sudah yedaha of these people cha anyascha sugrudam. All these people started giving them their own auspicious blessings, etc. His own people, unknown or unknown. Shubaha kadaha atma sambhujani. Those various stories or various anecdotes connected to Sri Rama as they were talking and praising him. What does Sri Rama do? Udasina. Udasina means this should not be misunderstood as he just doesn't care about it. Udasina. Udasina means sitting above. He is not affected by the praise or insult. That is the nature of Sri Rama. Ud means above. Asina. Bhagavan Krishna also uses this word very often. And also he says in many places, he the one who is always samam, is same. Whether it is sugadukkeshu samam, priya apriyeshu samam, manapamanayo samam, is remaining steadfast, equal, equanimous, unbalanced. That is the nature of Sri Rama. And therefore, in Shankaracharya also says in the sadhana panchakam. Janakrupa naishturyam utsrujyatam. People may praise you, people may insult you. Some people, those who praise only insult you also. You don't bother about that. Just you do your best and never take anything seriously, whether it's a praise or an insult. So this is the nature of Rama, even as he was praised to the hilt. Udasina. He remained unruffled, smilingly watching all of them, and he kept on going. Yayo Ramo Mahapadam. Oh, somebody praises us, we just stand there. Go ahead, go on. Somebody who insults, we don't even want to look at that person. You know? Is it not that happens very often when we are affected by anybody insults or anybody disrespects? We do not want to even look at the face of such a person because we are so afraid that that person will scorn at us. But if anybody praises and then we want to be in the company of that person, making that, you know, occasion to more and more enjoy ourselves. Here Sri Rama remained unruffled, moved there. But the beauty of Sri Rama is of this kind, balanced, so brilliant. Anybody who looked at him could not take their eyes away. Na kaschit tasman manak kaschit chakshusi vanarottama narashaknoti apakrishtum. Nobody could take away their eyes from him once they look at him. Tasman manah kaschit chakshusi va, whether the mind or the eyes, narottamat nashaknodi apakrishtum adikranto viragave. As he moved towards the palace, and everybody was so captivated by this beautiful, brilliant, valorous, strong, unruffled Sri Rama moving there. And it is said, yata, this line you should underline if you have the pen or anything. Yata yascha ramam na pashyetu yamcha namo na pashyati nindida sarva lokeshu swatma api enam vigarpate. When Rama does not see a person, or a person did not see a Rama, he is the most ridiculable person. Nindida has sarva lokeshu. He is going to be condemned in all the worlds. He who has not seen Rama, or whom Rama has not seen, he will be condemned in the three worlds. Not only that, even his own self will reject him. Sva atma api enam vigarhate. It is said in the Upanishads very beautifully that he who chooses the self chooses him exclusively. Meaning, what it means is, you know, in Jesus is a chosen one, Moses is a chosen one, they say, it is not that they are chosen, they chose God exclusively. Yam eva esha vrunate, tasya esha atma vivrunate tanum swam. He who chooses the self exclusively, the self chooses him exclusively. So if we don't choose the Bhagavan, it's not Bhagavan to be, you know, to be blamed, because we have become very preoccupied with so many other things. That's why Krishna also says, there are four kinds of devotees come to me, artho, jignyasu, rattarthi, those who want the physical health or money or knowledge, etc. But jnani, he chooses me and I choose him. Jnani to atma iva me matam. I consider jnani to be me myself. And between me and him, there is no difference at all. So, Sri Rama here representing our own Paramatma, the self. And we choose to not to see him, ignore him, we are actually ignoring our own self. Is it not that when a person, a father gets very upset with his son, don't he say, as far as I am concerned, you are dead. Meaning what? You know, when you are going very upset, as far as I am, so dead means what? I just completely ignore you. In the same way, here, he who has chosen to reject Sri Rama, actually he has rejected his own self. So, sarveshu sahi dharmatma, and he being the most virtuous, varnanam kurute dayam,
And he, irrespective of the caste of the person, he always shows so much of compassion. Chadurnam hi vayasthanam tenate tamanu vrataha. And he exclusively makes sure that he pays attention to each one of them, and they also in turn love him so much. All the various varnas, chadushpadan devapadan cha ityan cha ayatanani cha. Sri Rama, as he moved around in the various corners, there were temples, education institutions, and flag post of a temple, etc. He stopped there, pradakshinam pariharan. He made sure that he did the pradakshina of each of the temple before he proceeded on jagamadrupate sudaha. Finally, he went to the palace. One person was traveling from San Diego to, you know, Disneyland, and it takes maybe an hour and a half or something, but it took him 6 or 7 hours. So his wife was very worried. It took so much time for you to reach Disneyland from San Diego. What did you do? He said that, see, many places there were boats. I am a very honest person. I am a good citizen of this country. And many places on the road it is written, clean restroom. So I went and cleaned the restroom. Every place. So that's why it took more time. So, some people, every temple they go on round, round, round. But here Bhagavan Sri Rama also, because he is going for coronation, so he wants to make sure that he has the blessing of all the gods. So wherever there was a temple, he did a pravakshana and then moved on further. Finally, he reached the great abode of Dasharatha. Sarajakulama sadhya mega sangopamai shubaihi prasada shringai vividaihi kailasa shigaropamaihi avarayat birgaganam vimanairiva pandurai vardhamana grihaischapi ratnajala parishkrutai tat prativyam guhgrihavaram mahendra sadanopamam rajaputra rajaputra piturveshma Pravivesha Shriya Jvalan Sakakshya Dhanvabhir Guptaha Tisrodikramya Vajibihi Padadirapare Kakshye Dvejagama Narottamaha Sasarva Samadikramya Kakshya Dasharatatmajaha Samnivartya Janam Sarvam Shuddhanta Puramastyagad Tasmin Pravishte Pidurantikam Tada Janasya Sarvo Mudito Nripatmaje Pratikshate tasya punasma nirgamam Yatodayam chandramasa saritpatihi Sa rajagulam asadhya, having reached the abode of the king Dasharatha, and which is looking like a huge cloud, mega sanghopamai shubaihi, beautiful. So cloud means it's not one single, you know, collection of clouds. Imagine that in a blue sky you have collection of white clouds. How beautifully they are. Such was the mansions that were there. Prasada shringaihi vividaihi, most beautiful palaces there. Kailasa shikara upamaihi, equal to that of the beauty of Kailasa. Avarayat bihi, being covering gaganam, the entire space as though being covered by the vimana of those beautiful palaces. Vimana means the main shelter or main abode there. Vimanairiva pandurehi vardhaman. Nowadays what we see, you know, you can't even see the space, right? Sky. Because the sky scrappers. What's it called? Sky? Sky scrappers? Scrapers. As though they are going to pierce into the sky. And if you go to downtown, etc., you look up, you won't see anything, only the concrete jungle there. So in the same way, there, those times, they had huge skyscrapers there. Vardhamana grihesh chabi, and also kingly abodes, and how they are decorated, ratna jala parishkrutaihi. Parishkrutaihi decorated with ratna jala. Ratna jala means precious stones have become the net all over the place. In that way they were decorated. Tat prithivyam grihavaram, best of the world class mansions. Mahendra sadanopamam, equal to that of abode of Mahendra. Rajaputraha Sri Ramaha Pituhu Veshma Prabhivesha. He entered the Dasharatha's palace Shriyajvalan. And at the same time, when he enters, his beauty is his own tejas, sees his beauty. Not having in his about his cloth and everything was not much explained, because his beauty is his own shriya, his own greatness. Sakakshya danvibihi guptaha. He entered first three chambers were guarded by people with bow in the hand, standing there as a guard for Dasharatha. Danvibihi means dhanu, they are holding the dhanu, that is the bow. Guptaha, guards. Tisro dikramya vajibihi, with the horses. He was going still in the chariot. He crossed the three chambers protected by the great soldiers, guards there. Then last two chambers, padadira pare kakshye dve jagama narottama. He got down from the chariot and started walking towards the last two chambers. Sasarvaha samadikramya, having crossed all of them, kakshadasharatatmanajaha, he reached the abode, final abode of Dasharatha. At that point, he looked at all of them, including Lakshmana. Stay back. Everybody stay back. I want to go, because I was the only one asked to go there. So, sannivartyas janam sarvam, all of them leaving behind, shuddhantapuram atyagat. He approached and went into the abode of Dasharatha. The people who were standing outside, you know, they anxiously waited for him. Taspin pravishte piturantikam tada janasya sarva mudito nripatmaje. Nripatmaje pravishte. And when he entered that abode of Sri Dasharatha, the people who were standing there with great delightful heart, they waited for him. Tasya punahasma nirgamam pratikshate. For him to return, come out. Everybody waited there, and how it is, it's beautiful. Simile is given, yatodayam chandramadas saritpatihi. Just like the ocean waits for the moonrise. At the end of the day, or during the day, scorching heat of the sun has been making this ocean water very hot, and as the sunset takes place, how much this heated ocean waits for the cool moon to appear. In the same way, all people standing outside waited anxiously for Rama to come out. Ityashe Srimat Ramayane Valmiki Adikavya Ayodhya Kande Saptadasha Sargaha 17. We'll read a little portion of the 18 because that's the most climax that is coming up now. He entered the abode of Dasharatha, and what does he see there? Sadadashasane Ramo Vishannam Pitaram Shubhe
Kaikeya Sahitam Dinam.
Kaikeya Sahitam Dinam.
Mukena Parishushyata.
Mukena Parishushyata.
Sapiturcharanau Purvam. Abhivadya Vinitavat. Tato Vavante Charanau. Kaikeya Susamahitah. Ramityuktva tu vachanam. Bashvaparya kulekshanah. Shashaka dupadirdino. Nekshitum nabibhashitum. Tadapurvam narapatehe. Drishtvarupam vayavaham. Ramopi vayamapannah. Padasprushteva pannagam. Indriyera prushteistam. Shoga santapa karshitam. Nishvasantam Maharajam. Vedita Kula Chetasam. Sa Ramaha Asane Pitaram Kaikeya Sahitam Dinam Mukena Parishushyata Kaikeya Sahitam Dinam Vishannam Pitaram Darsha. Sri Rama saw at the very seat of Dasharatha, the one who was seated there was completely crestfallen, sad, sitting there with the face which is completely dried out, with Kaikeyi next to him. Kaikeyi asagidam deenam, pitiable, painful. Mukena parishushyata, the face fully dried up. But as soon as he saw that, first, he could not understand what is happening. But first thing he did was, Sa Piduhu Charanau Purvam Abhibhadya. He went and saluted the feet of his father, Vinitavat, with all humility. Tataha, thereafter, Bhavante, he worshipped Charanau Kaikeya Susamahitah. With a mind calm and quiet, he went and touched the feet of Kaikeyi also with all reverence. And at that time, Dasharatha looked at him, Hey Rama! He uttered only that much, Rama yadyuktva tu vachanam bhashvaparya kulekshanah. Eyes filled with tears, nirpatehe dinah, the nirpati, this Dasharatha, painful, pitiable, na ikshidum, na abhibhashidum shashaka. Even he could not see Rama properly, much less he was able to speak a funny word at all. No, when Sri Rama looked at him, Tad apurvam narapayate srishtva. Seeing father in that condition which he has never seen before. Apurvam. Purvam means if you have seen before. Apurvam narapate drishtva rupam bhayavaham. He became afraid. Bhayavaham rupam srishtva ramobhi bhayam apannah. Looking at the frightening part, I mean face of his father, he also became so frightened. It is like what? Yata sprishta sprishteva pannagam. If you happen to touch by foot a snake, just imagine. You know, when we were studying in our Sandipani, you know, in way back in 23 years back. So we used to have behind our temple there in Shiva temple, there used to be a huge python. Not python, what do you call that?
Cobra.
Black, huge, at least 10 feet. People have said about it and then we have not seen it. One day, late in the afternoon, in the summer, when I was, it was a rainy season, I was just walking by and suddenly I saw on a concrete thing, black, you know, huge, it was moving about. You just can't do anything, you just wait.
only pray that he doesn't look at you. This much size. The trunk of the body of this size. Black. It's a slimy shine. I'm giving you all descriptions that night you will not sleep today. So I saw that, and that whole night I could not sleep. Next morning, when I was to early morning, we go for the chanting into the temple, 5:30 or so. Usually I go early, you know. That day I knocked the next door. The boy, no, yes. What do you want? Hey, are you coming for chanting? Of course. So, let us go together. Huh? You usually go much before what happened. You just come. By the time you heard about from others also that I have seen this snake. So, as we were walking near that area, he said, see, here. I got frightened. I jumped on him. Imagine you touching that slimy thing. In that way, Sri Rama was so frightened. Pada sprushteva pannagam. Indrihi abrugrishtehi tam shoka santapakarshitam. Most unpleasant sense abilities and so sindriyehi abrugrishtehi. With the sense dried up, senses dried up. Shoka santapakarshitam. With sorrow, grief stricken. Nishvasantam with long sigh, Maharajam Vedita Akula Chetesam, mind completely depressed and agitated, stand sitting there. When Sri Rama looked at it, Urmimalinamakshobhyam Shubhyantam Iva Chagaram Vapludam ivadityam Uktan rudam rishim tada Achintya kalpam rupatehe Tam shokam abadharayan Babuva samratta tarah Samudra iva parvani. Chintayamasa chaturaha Rama piduhite rataha Kimsit atyeva nrupatihi Namam pratyabhinandati Anyatamam pita drishtva Upito viprasidati Tasyama madhya samprekshya Himayasa pravartate Sadina iva sokarto Vishannavadana dyutihi Kaikeyim abhivadyeva Ramo vachanam abravit. So here, Urmimalin is the ocean, Sagaraha. Sagaram Urmimalinam Akshobhyam. Akshobhyam means unruffled. Even though many waves are there, ocean is not disturbed usually. But if ocean were to be disturbed by the waves, that is how Dasharatha was looking like. Akshobhyam Kshubhyantam Iva. Just like the ocean unruffled by its own waves, how if when its own waves can disturb him, in that way Dasharatha was looking so grief stricken. And also another example he gives, Upapladam iva adityam, as though the sun was eclipsed. If the moon eclipsed, it is okay, it is not as much effective, but sun bright and brilliant, when it starts becoming dark on a daytime, how it is such an inauspicious thing. Another example. Ukta anrudam rishim yata. Just like a very well known sage. He catches himself telling a lie. How much his face will show that. You know, because a nobility of a person is in the truthfulness, and he himself is telling the lie, how his face will lose its tejas. That kind of a sorrow-stricken face was achintya kalpam rupatehe. It is unimaginable is the face of that Dasharatha. Shokam upadharayan, seeing such a face of the father which is full of grief. Samrapta daraha babuva samudra iva parvani. Even Sri Rama grew very concerned. Samrapta daraha babuva, he became very concerned. Like what? Samudra iva parvani, on a full moon day, how the waters of the ocean gets disturbed. In the same way, he was quite disturbed and looking at the father. Chintayamasa, he started thinking, Chaturo Ramaha, most smart and most brilliant Rama, Pituhite Rataha, always Pitruhite, always thinking about the welfare of his own father. Kimsvid Adyeva Nrupatihi Namam Pratyabhinandati. Usually he salutes and, I mean, he welcomes me with so much of joy. Why he today, he has not in his own self, he didn't do that. In many times, even when he is angry, Pita Kupite Api, Kupitaha Api, even when he is actually, gets angry, Anyada Mam Drishtva Prasidati. When he otherwise also, he would see and smile at me. Tasya mam adya sampreksha kim ayasa pravartate. But today when he looked at me, he doesn't want to look at me. And he looks away or he looks very disturbed. There is something seriously going on here. And therefore, sa dhinaha eva shokartaha, with so much of grief in his own mind, Vishanna Vadana Dyutihi, with his face also losing luster, Kaikeyim Abhivadyeva, saluting Kaikeyi, Ramaha Vachanam Abravid. He asked Sri, Kaikeyi, please tell me, what is it that has gone wrong with my father? You are the one who is next to him right now. You are the only person who can tell me. And it's because if it had been known to everybody outside, it would not be such a celebration. The celebration is going on and everybody seemed to be in a high spirit. But inside it's just the opposite. So there is something which is going on here which she would only know. So therefore he asks her, we'll see tomorrow. Aganita Gunagana Bhushana Rama Ashrita Vatsala Jaya Jaya Rama Ayodhya Vasi Sita Rama Apad Bandava Jaya Jaya Rama Dasharata Nandana Sri Rama Dashamukha Mardana Jaya Jaya Rama Kausalya Sukha Vardana Rama Kamita Palata Jaya Jaya Rama Papa Vimochana Sri Rama Pattabhi Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Janaki Vallabha Sita Rama Jaya Raghu Rama Jaya Siya Rama Vanara Sevita Sri Rama Varidi Vandita Jaya Jaya Rama Hanumat Pujita Sita Rama Jaya Raghu Rama Jaya Siya Rama Raghupati Raghava Raja Rama
Patita Pavana Sita Rama.
Patita Pavana Sita Rama.
Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Rama. चंद्र की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय उमापति महादेव की जय बोलो भई सब संत।